It was just a normal day. It was a really, really nice day, and our mom called and said that we were walking home.
They actually like walking home. They don't get to do that very often, so I called school and just said to go ahead and send them, you know, that they could walk home.
So we were walking home, and previous that day, my friend had given me some candy because she's not a fan of candy. So me and Lukey sat down on the bench and we were just eating some of that candy together.
And then they started running and I think Lily kind of tripped and stumbled. And then I noticed that she couldn't really like breathe and she was like kind of like starting to tear up and cry.
I knew that my mom, she told me like stay calm when you're going through something like that. So I'm running through my head, I'm just like, okay, just breathe through your nose. And I couldn't do that either. I knew to go like this, but like I wanted to do something more like so that Anthony could really tell what was wrong.
There's a poster in our lunchroom at our old school, kind of hanging up where you get your milk carton. The title's like, what to do if someone's choking. And I kind of looked at that every day because there's really nothing else to look at. I didn't really do the Heimlich maneuver. I just kind of did a bear hug and kind of squeezed.
And the candy came out. After that, I couldn't like breathe very well. My voice was really raspy and stuff.
I wanted her to catch her breath, so I let her sit down on the bench that was coming up. And once she caught her breath, I think I had a water bottle in my bag. And so I gave her a little bit of water and then I let her take a break and then we kept walking.
When they came home, Lily was the first one to tell me. She said, Mom, we were walking home and I choked. And I said, really? Did you start coughing? You know, kind of thinking that maybe it wasn't actually a full-blown choke. You know, were you coughing a lot? You know, you had something stuck in your throat. She said, no, Mom, I couldn't breathe. I was really scared and Anthony saved me.
Through life, you raise your kids and you teach them the right things to do. You know, this is the right way to add, this is the right way to read. And it's one thing to know what to do, but when to know when to do them and how to do them the right way or in some way. Lily was able to stay calm and to be able to indicate that she was in distress and for Anthony to recognize that, oh man, this is a time where I need to act. And it's just like, wow, my kids did this. You know, a fifth grader changed the life of course of our family potentially. It's really powerful.
He's, you know, the kind of kid that's always looking out for others and, you know, when those things happen, you know, I think Anthony's a good guy to have at your side.
He really, really helped me that day. It doesn't feel like enough to say thank you. He's a better brother than I thought he was. And that if I really need help, then he'd take care of me.